Present 66 liters of mixture of goa and cucumber and aloe vera in the ratio 5:4:2. 11 liters of this mixture is taken out and x liters of each of the three juices is added in the jar. If the resultant quantity of goa juice is twice the quantity of aloe vera juice, what is the value of x? So initially how many liters we have? And how many parts are these total? And 11 liters are taken out. In the sense, one part is equal to 1 liter. So remaining goa quantity is 5 parts minus 5. See, idu kuda avasaram illa. From 66 liters, 11 liters is taken out. Remaining 55. So these 55 are also in the same ratio, 5:4:2. So goa is 5 parts, which is 5 times 20, 5 liters. And aloe vera, 2 parts, that is 10. And after this, x liters of each quantity is added, it becomes 2:1 ratio. Correct? From this, x is equal to, go for cross multiplication. 25 plus x is equal to 20 plus 2x, then x is equal to 5. Right, that's what your question. A square is inscribed in a circle in such a way that its diameter is the diagonal of the square. They need not to mention this point. That indirectly says that we have a circle, and if one square is inscribed here, diagonal of square should be equal to diameter of circle. The area of the square is 392. What is the circumference of the circle? Circumference, first of all, what is the verification? 11 multiple. 3 are there? Yes. Hence, we have to calculate. Now, square area is equal to 392, which is a square, right? Yes. Yes. Now, d square is equal to, 2a square. 2 times of this. What is 2 times of this number? 784. This is which number square? 28 square. So diagonal is equal to 28. Then radius becomes 14. You're asked about circumference. 2 pi, 22 by 7 into radius. 7 how many times? 2 times. Answer, 88. Right? Sum of x rupees was invested for 2 years in scheme A and B in the ratio 4:5. Scheme A and scheme B both offers compound interest at 10% and 20% per annum. If the total amount in total interest earned was 3040, what is the value of x? So x rupees is divided into how many parts? 9 parts. So that must be a total multiple of 9 multiple. All are 9 multiples. Hence we have to calculate. Let me take this as 400% and 500% for calculation purpose. Now, scheme A offers 10%, compound interest for 2 years at 10% per annum is 21%. 21% of 400. How much is that? 84%. Next, compound interest for 2 years at 20% per annum is 44% of 500. How much is that? 220. 220% and 84%. Total interest obtained? 304%, which is equal to 3050. Total how much percent we have? 900%. Should be equal to 9000. Next. A bag contains 8 red balls, some blue balls and 2 green balls. One ball is drawn at random if the probability that the ball is red is 2 by 5. So it is 2 parts by 5 parts. How many red balls we have? 8. In how many ways can you select one ball? 8C one ways, which is 8. Total so far how many balls are already there? 10. Plus X balls from blue. That is 10 plus X. 2 parts is equal to 8. 2, how many times is 8? 4 times. 5 into 4? 20. So this denominator should be equal to 20. Then x is equal to 10. Followed. Next. ABC is a right angle triangle. Length of AB and AC are 24 and 18. This is 24 and this is 18. What is the area of this shaded region? Right. So as this is a right angle triangle, this is hypotenuse, right? Opposite square plus adjacent side square should be equal to hypotenuse square. 24 square plus 18 square. 30. Or else this is 24 and this is 18. 6 how many times? 3 times. 6 how many times? You know Pythagoras triplet, right? Combination. 3 is to 4 is to 5. 6 into 5, 30. Followed? Right. So for circle, what is this 30 called? Diameter. Radius becomes 15. Area of the circle is pi r square, which is pi r. What is r? 15. 15 square, 225. Full circle area is equal to pi r square, but that is semicircle, that is by 2. Minus, what is that we have to subtract now? Area of the triangle. Right angle triangle, opposite side and adjacent side are 18 and 24. Yes or no? Half BH? That is half BH. 2 how many times? 9 times. 24 9 times. 24 10 times 240 minus 24 1 time. That is 216. And here it is 112.5 into pi. Only option. What is only option? For what? Yeah, yeah. Pi value calculate this octave. Yes. Followed? Next. The radius of circular garden is 1 meter less than the side of the square. A 2 meter wide path runs around the square garden. If the total cost of graveling the path at the rate of 15 rupees was 1200. What is the circumference of the circular garden? Circumference 2 pi r. Answer should be 11 multiple. All are 11 multiple. So we have to calculate. Now, there is a square garden. And outside the square, there is a path whose width is given as 2. Yes or no? So path area should be, if you are take inner square side as x, outer square side becomes x plus 4. Yes or no? Path area is equal to outer square area minus inner square area. That is x plus 4 whole square minus x square. And the cost was given as 1200 at the rate of 15 rupees. Yes or no? Per square meter. Then what is the area 1200 by 15? How much is that? 80. From this, you need to calculate x value. But radius of the circle is 1 less than side of the square. And after that, you need to calculate circumference, which is 2 pi into radius. Yes or no? Wait a minute. Using this, I don't want to calculate it here. Radius should be what multiple? Radius should be 7 multiple. Let me take r is equal to 7. In that case, x minus 1 is equal to 7. Then x is equal to 8. Let us substitute 8 here. If x is equal to 8, x square? 64. X plus 4 in the sense 8 plus 4. 144. 12 square. 144 minus 64. What is that? Satisfied? Hence x is equal to 8. Radius is equal to 7. Let me substitute 7 here. Answer 44. Followed. If not verified, in place of 7, we have to consider 14. Then x becomes 15. And then you will verify with x as 15. Okay now? Sure everybody? Right. Don't try to calculate it from the equation, it takes time. Don't try to solve it and get the value of x. Every time, just think about the next step. One step, ebo alochinchadam, maatladukovali, nechukovali. Come on, next. Tank T has x liters of water and has two outlet pipes, A and B. Tap B was opened for 2 hours and then tap A was also opened along with tap B for next 2 hours. After 4 hours, tank T had 3000 liters. Tap A alone can empty the tank in 12 hours and B can empty the tank in 8 hours. What was the value of X? Right, come on. So, initially tap B was open. Worked alone for 2 hours. After 2 hours, A also opened. And now, together worked for 2 more hours. In a sense, out of total 4 hours, tap B worked for 4 hours. A worked for 2 hours. A can completely fill the tank, empty the tank in 12 hours. In 2 hours it can empty 1/6. Yes? And B can empty the tank in 8 hours. But B worked for 4 hours. It can empty half the tank. Can I take 1 by 2 as 3 by 6? 1 by 6 plus 3 by 6. 4 by 6. 4 by 6 in the sense? 2/3. So if 2/3 is emptied, then remaining is 1/3, which is equal to how many liters? 3000 liters. Still tank has 3000 liters, which is 1/3. If 1/3 is 3000, then total tank capacity? Over 9000. Followed? Ramu's present age is equal to the twice of Soam's age 4 years hence. 4 years ago, Ramu's age at that time was thrice Soam's age at that time. What is Ramu's present age? Okay. First of all, Ramu's present age is equal to 2 times. 2 times in the sense answer should be even number, right? If there is only one even number, you are done. But 4 are there. So, first equation is not enough to get the answer. 4 years ago, Ramu's age was how many times? Thrice. 4 years back, it was three parts. Three parts should be 3 multiple, right? To get present age, you need to add 4 years. Am I right? Again, can I write 4 years as 3 plus 1? Come on. 3 parts plus 3 also should be 3 multiple. So Ramu's present age should be in the form of 3 multiple plus 1. Yes or no? First of all, last answer cannot be your answer because that is odd number. This cannot be your answer because that is perfect multiple of 3. This cannot be your answer because that is perfect multiple of 3. Our answer should be 3 multiple plus 1. Can you write 40 as 3 multiple plus 1? Yes. 39 plus 1? Possible. Can you write 20 as 3 multiple plus 1? No way. This is not possible. Right answer 40. Followed. 4 years back, 3 multiple. Present age should be 3 multiple plus 4. Again in 4 also we have 3 multiple plus 1 we have. So final answer should be multiple of 3 plus 1. And this is the only option which is possible. Okay. Right. Next. Mohan bought 2 articles A and B at a total cost of 2400. He marked article A at 40% and article B at 20% above their respective cost basis. He sold both the articles at 25% discount on each on their market prices. Fine. If the selling price of A is more than that B by 180 rupees, what is the cost of article B? Now, total cost together is 2400. Let's say cost price of A is 100% of A and B is 100% of B. Okay? Now, your question is about B. Let it be X. Then cost price of A becomes 2400 minus X. He initially marked it A as 40% above the cost price. So it becomes 140%. And again after that he is giving discount of 25%. 25% discount on 140 is 35. If 35 discount is given, he will be selling it at 105%. 105% of 2400 minus 6 is selling price of item A. Yes. And next, item B. He increased value by 20%, becomes 120%, again giving 25% discount, which is 30. 120% minus 30 is 90%. So other value becomes 90% of X. Difference between both the selling prices is given as 180. 105% of this number. What is 5%? What is 10%? 240. 5%? 120. Then it becomes 2520. Take 180 to left hand side, that becomes minus. Which is equal to left hand side you have minus 105%, minus 90%, that becomes 195%. Right? Subtract 180. What do you get? 2340, which is equal to 195%. From this we have to calculate 100%. Okay, now 195, 10 times 1950. Again you need to add 390. 390 will be how many times? 2 times. This is 10 times and this is 2 times. Total 12 times. Answer 1200. Followed? Then everybody. Next. Four-fifths of total population of village A were literates, three-fifths of total literates and three-fifths of total illiterates were male. If the sum of female illiterates and female literates was 2400, what was the total population of the village? See, total population will ideally will have male and female. In male, you will have literates and illiterates. And female also, literates and illiterates. Now, can I take 3 by 5 as 60%? And here also this is 60%. Are you getting my point? So, total population will have literates and illiterates. Out of this part, if 60% are male, and out of this part, if 60% are male, out of total also 60% are male. If total male population percentage wise is 60%, then female 40%, and which is equal to female literates and female illiterates, which is 2400. Total population is 100%. 40, 60 times, 160 times over. Yes? Followed everybody? Next, the respective ratio between 1/4 of a number and 5/6 of another number is 1:4. A is to B, or you can write it as A by B. 1/4 of number, X by 4. 5/6 of another number, denominator and denominator comes to numerator. Yes or no? 4/4 cancel? Matladali. From this X by Y is equal to? 5 by 6. That is 5 parts, 6 parts. Total how many parts? Answer 11 multiple? Only one, 44. You're asked about sum of numbers. X plus Y, which is 5 parts plus 6 parts. Total 11 parts, 11 multiple, only one is there. Followed? Next. Train A of length X meters and a cyclist starts traveling from point A in the same direction. Train A traveling at 20 meter per second can cross the cyclist covering at a certain speed in t seconds. Train B of length x minus 32 meters, if it also starts from point A, traveling at 19 meter per second, can cross the same cyclist traveling at the same speed in t seconds. What is the value of t? Now, what is the time taken in first, what is the speed in first case? 20 meter per second. Of course, this is train speed. Both man and train, both are moving in the same direction. That is minus speed. Relative speed, S1 minus S2. Train speed minus man speed. By. What is the speed in second case? 19 meter per second. Yeah, let me take it as 20 minus x by 19 minus x. In second case also, train B is trying to cross a cyclist who is also moving in the same direction. Are you getting my point? What is this I am taking now? Speed of the train in first case or relative speed in first case by relative speed in second case. Yes or no? How do you get speed? Distance by time. What is the time taken? T. Okay, na? Right. What is the distance traveled in first case? Already xn start chesanga 20 minus man speed, 19 minus man speed, relative speed, that is distance by time. What is distance traveled? X meters. And in second case, x minus 32. Anyway, by t will be there, both gets cancelled, hence I don't want to write. Followed? You should write x by t by x minus 32 by t. Okay, now again, even if you write, that gets cancelled. What is difference in terms of parts here? One part. And here it is 32. Then one part is equal to 32, t is equal to 32. Sorry. Distance travelled in the first case, x, which is equal to 20 minus man speed into t. Distance in second case, x minus 32, which is equal to 19 minus man speed into t. If you solve it, difference in both the cases is 32. Difference here is 20t minus mt, 19t minus mt, mt gets cancelled. 20t minus 19t is t, which is equal to over. Followed? Next. Sum invested in scheme A is half that invested in scheme B. Let's say in scheme B, principal is 100% and in scheme A it becomes, come on, 50%. Both the schemes offered simple interest per annum. At the end of 3 years, the sum received from scheme B offered at 12% per annum was more than the sum invested in scheme A by 4,300. Amount received in scheme B at 12% per annum after 3 years. At the rate of 12% per annum, simple interest for 3 years, 36%. Amount received? 136%. This is amount received. Is more than the sum invested by what person? Hey, sum invested by what percent more? 86%. Me, padi, rendu difference abba. What is difference between these two? 86. Which in terms of rupees is given as 4,300. In scheme A, principal invested is 50%. 86 half into 100. 50 half into 100. Yes, what is 4,300? Difference of amount received from scheme B after 3 years and principal invested in scheme A. Followed? Right. ABC started a business and invested for different time periods, which are in the respective ratio 6:4:3. The amount invested by A is 600 rupees less than that invested by B, And the amount invested by B was 1200 less than that of by investment of C. The share of profit received by A was 225 and the total profit earned was 650. What is the amount invested by A? Right. So ABC investment periods are in the ratio 6, 4, 3. A's investment depends on B. B's investment depends on C. Yes, your question is about investment of A. Let's start with X. And B investment becomes X plus 600. And C investment becomes X plus 1800. Yes or no? That becomes 6X, 4X plus 2400, 3X plus 5400. So what is X part here? 6X. Out of total, 13x plus 7,800. 13x plus 7,800. Which is equal to, A's profit is 225 out of total 650. How many 25s are here? 9. How many 25s are here? 26. So, this ratio is equal to 9 by 26. Take 13 common here, 13, 1 times 13, 600 times, and this is 2 times. 12x is equal to 9x plus 5400, 3x is equal to 5400, x is equal to 1800. Yes. Mansi and Vijay have some money. 55% of Mansi's money is 3000 less than Vijay's money. Vijay's money is 30% more than Mansi. Suppose if Mansi's money is 100%, Vijay's money becomes 130%. And now, according to first statement, 55% of Mansi's money is 3000 less than Vijay's money. Yes or no? What is difference here? 75%. 75% is equal to 3000. Then 100% is equal to 4000. 30% is equal to 1200. 130% is equal to 5200. Total sum of money of both Mansi and Vijay is 9200. Or else you can directly go for 230 multiple, 23 multiple. How many 23 multiples are there? Only one, 92. You asked about sum, right? 100% plus 130%, that is total 230%. Answer should be 23 multiple. There is only one 23 multiple here. Matladru. Every month, Ananya spends 20% of her monthly income on paying bills and 30% of the remaining on purchasing household items, and the remaining amount she invests in fixed deposits and mutual funds in the ratio 9:5. 20% is over, remaining 80%. Out of 80, 30% is done, which is 24. Remaining 56%. And this is divided into how many parts? 14 parts. 14 how many times is 56? 14, 14. 9 fours, 36%. 5 fours, 20%. Now, if she invests 14,400 in fixed deposit, what percent is spent? 36%, which is equal to 14,400. From this, what is your question about? How much she is paying per year on paying bill? On paying bills, what percent she is spending? 20%. Yeah, we'll come to that later. Monthly, 36 four times, 00. 24 times, 00. Yes or no? And this is per month, per year in the sense, into 12. 12 into 8, 96, and then 3 zeros. Got it? Next. Otherwise, per month if savings, paying bill is 20%, per year that is into 12, that is 240. 36% is equal to 14400. 240% is equal to how much? 36 double 240 double double is 960 and then 2 zeros direct. Or else 20% into 12 is your answer. Answer should be what multiple? 3 multiple. No, no, no. There are two options. Hence you have to calculate. There is no other way. Okay. Three zeros. Both are possible. Next, 107. In a class of 32 students, number of boys exceeds number of girls by 8. In the sense, boys are 20, girls are 12. Yes. The average weight of girls is more than boys by 10. If boys' average is x, girls' average is x plus 10. Okay. If the average weight of the whole class is 33, 3 by 4 kgs. What is the difference between total weight of the girls and total weight of the boys? Yes? What is total weight of boys? 20x. Total weight of girls? 12x plus 120. What is total? 32x plus 120. That should be equal to number of students into average. What is average? 33, 3 by 4. Can we take 33, 3 by 4 as 32 plus 1 plus 3 by 4? Yes or no? You have to multiply entire number with what? 32. 32's? 1024. 1024 plus 32 ones? 1024 plus 32. And 3 by 4 can be written as 75%? 75% of 32. 50% plus half of that. 50%. 16. Again half of that. 8. 16 plus 8. 20. How much is total? 1000? 80. Sum of this, 1080. 320x, 320 na 32 gada. 32x plus 120 is equal to 1080. 32x is equal to, take 120 to right hand side, that becomes 960. Then x is equal to, come on, 30. You're asked about difference. Boys sum is 20x. Girls sum is 12 into x plus 10. What is x value? 30. 20 into 30. Hey, 20 into 30. 600. 12 into 40. 480. Difference of these two? Fourth option. Yes. One out eight. 36 men can complete a piece of work in 14 days. 24 women can complete the same piece of work in 27 days. What is the difference between the amount of work done by 42 men in one day, 18 women in 2 days? One man can complete the work in 36 into 14 days. 42 men worked for only one day. This is work done by men. 14 how many times? 3 by 36 in the sense? 1 by 12. This is work done by men. One woman can complete the work in 24 into 27 days. 18 women worked for 2 days. 9 2 times? 9 3 times. 4 6 times. that is equal to 1 by 80. Can we take this number as 3 by 36? Matladali. Can we take this number as 2 by 36? Difference between these two numbers? 1 by 36. Third option. A boat takes total of 11 hours to travel upstream from A to B and downstream from B to C. Distance between B and C is twice that of distance from AB. If AB distance is X, BC distance becomes 2X. The speed of the boat in still water is 16 and speed of the current is 4. What is the distance between A to B? We are asked to calculate X value. A to B X. A to B is which stream? Upstream, M minus S, 12, X by 12. Distance covered with the speed 12 km per hour. Second case, distance covered is 2X, and which is downstream, M plus S, 20, and which is equal to 11. S, X must be 12 multiple. Matladali. Is first option 12 multiple? Second option? Third option? Kani X 240 aithe 240 by 12 ante 20 hours kada. But what is our time given? So this cannot be your answer. Is your fifth option 12 multiple? Answer? Over. Sixty by 12? 5. 2 into 60 in the sense 120. 120 by 26. Is sum of these two numbers equal to 11? Satisfied. Don't try to solve the equation. Even if you solve it, you will get the same. ADEF is a rectangle. ADEF. AB and DC are arcs of circles centered at F and E. In the sense, you have circle like this. Whose center is E? You have one more circle like this. Whose center is F? Okay, now, matladali. Right. This is rectangle. If breadth is 4, here AF also 4, yes. Yes or no? Take this triangle to this side, then it will be something like this, which is semicircle, shaded area in the sense, rectangle area, that is 12 into 4, 48 minus semicircle area, yes or no? What is AD called for for circle? Radius. Yes or no? Ante. Radius is 4. Pi r square by 2. Answer pi lone undi. Pi, radius is 4 square, which is 16 by 2. 2 how many times? 8 times. Take 8 common, 6 minus pi. Yes. Number of employees, male and female. Percentage of science graduate out of total number and number of male employees. Okay, come on. Number of other graduate employees in our chapala idi. Should I discuss? It's already 5. Andukane adugutunna. Cheppante chepta. If you want to specific question also fine. If you want me to skip, I can. Tell me, what do you want? Should I discuss? Mm. 75% of this number. What is this 240, right? Half of 240? I mean to say 50%. 120. Yes or no? 25%? 60. Sum? 180. 61 divided by 3? 20. Over. First option. Next. 13 square, 169, minus 6 square, 36, that is 133 by 5. By 5 in the sense 20%, or by 10 into 2, by 10 is 13.2, 13.3, into 2 in the sense 26.6, approximately 27. Don't try to divide number with 5, divide it by 10 into 2. By 10 is 13.3, double it, 26.6. 352 into 2 divided by 8. 8 how many times? 4 times. 4, 8 times and then again 8 times. Plus x by 15 is equal to 41. Take 25 to right hand side. Minus 25. How much is that? 16. X by 15 is equal to 16. Then x is equal to 15 into 16. 16 10 times 160. 16 5 is 80. Total 240. Anna 400 into 2 kada ikkada. 404 into 2. Okay. How many 400s are here? How many 400s are here? Total how many 400s are there? Add చేయటం కూడా అవసరమా మనకి 126 what is this data sufficiency come on what is the speed of the boat in upstream there is m minus s correct a boat can travel 9.6 kilometers in downstream in 36 minutes using this will you get answer no you will get downstream speed which is m plus s Can we calculate M minus S from here? No way. If you know man speed also? Yes. If you know stream speed?
Yes.
And downstream? Yes. Apart from downstream, you need some other value. Either man speed or stream speed. One alone is not sufficient. Next. The respective ratio of the speeds of boat in still water and speed of the water current is 7:1. Using 2L and will you get answer? No. Man speed to stream speed ratio is 7:1. From this, man speed is 7 parts, stream speed 1 part, downstream speed 8 parts. Using 1 alone, you can calculate downstream, right? Which is equal to 8 parts. From that, can't we calculate upstream, which is 6 parts? So 1 and 2, both are required. Next. What is B's investment in the business? A started the business with X rupees. After 4 months from the start of the business, B joined with X plus 400. A's investment, B's investment X plus 2400. Okay? So B joined after 4 months. Using 1 alone, will you get answer? No way. Next. A invested for less than a year. The respective ratio of profit earned by AB is 35:27. Using 2 alone, will you get investment of B? No way. Using 1 and 2? No. Because you don't know time period of A. They said less than a year. How many? 11 months, 10 months, 9 months, 8 months. That information is not there. If you know that, if A invested for 12 months, investment of B becomes 4 months less than that, that becomes A. Using this, can we calculate profit sharing ratio or not? Which is equal to ratio given in second option, which is 35:27. Investment of A into time period of A. Investment of B into time period of B. Using this, can we calculate X value? Then, can we calculate X plus 2400? Yes. You can get the answer if you know what? Time period of A. But instead of that, they said, A invested less than a year. So that time period is not clearly mentioned. Hence answer cannot be determined. Okay na? Ide question lo. Ippudu answer? Both 1 and 2. Because you know time period of A which is 12 months. Got it? In how many days B alone can finish the whole project? A started the project and after 18 days was replaced by B. B finished the remaining work in 5 days. Is one alone sufficient? B is 20% more efficient than A. Is two alone sufficient? Is one and two sufficient? Yes. To complete remaining work, B required 5 days. A with 100% efficiency worked for 18 days. If B works this work with 120% efficiency, how many days are required? 20, 5 times, 20, 6 times, 6, 3 times. That is 15 days. So whatever the work done by A here we have in 18 days, B completes the same work in 15 days and remaining work in 5 days and total work in 20 days. Will you get answer or not? Yes. 1 and 2, both are required. Followed? In the same question, if I give you some other information here, after 18 days, and finished 2/3 work, is one alone sufficient? Yes or no? If A completed 2/3 work, remaining is 1/3. 1/3 is done by B in 5 days, then total can be done in 15 days. So even if you know the fractional part of the total work done by A, then also you can complete the work. Either A or B, whatever. B finished remaining 1/4 work. Whatever the case, if you know the fractional part of the work done by either A or B, you can calculate the answer. Oh, no? Next. In a vessel, there are 40 liters of mixture of milk and water. The quantity of milk in the mixture is X liters. What is the value of X? Let's say X. What is the value of X? Okay, no? Come on. How many liters quantity we have? 40. If 8 liters of this mixture is taken out and replaced with 8 liters of water. And this action is repeated once more. That is, 8 liters of this mixture was taken out and replaced with 8 liters of water. The remaining quantity of milk in the mixture will be 16 liters. Will you get answer using one alone?
Yes.
Initially, what is total quantity? 40. Which is combination of milk and water. From this, how many liters is taken out?
18.
Which is 20%, right?
Yes.
And after that, what is that you are adding? Same quantity of water. So milk quantity is not changing. After that, you are not adding. Yes or no? Suppose, if I start this as 100% of milk, 20% is taken out, remaining will be 80%. Again the same quantity of water we are adding, again quantity will be 40 liters, again from this you are taking 8 liters out, again that is 20%, yes or no? Again 20% of 80% of milk becomes 16, that becomes 64% of milk, which is given as 16 liters. Then initial quantity of milk is 100%, that is equal to 25. 64 becomes 16 divided by 4. 100 divided by 4, 25. Okay. So what is milk quantity in initial container? 25 liters out of 40. So water is 15 liters. Followed? Clear everybody? Next. Is 1 LN sufficient? Obvious. If 5 liters of water is added to the mixture, respective ratio of milk and water in the mixture is 5:4. Initially, how many liters quantity of milk and water we have? 40. When you add 5 liters, it becomes 45. That is divided into how many parts? 9 parts. 1 part, 5. 5 parts, 25. 4 parts, 20. Milk is 25, water is 20. Over. Is 2 alone sufficient? Yes. 1 alone or 2 alone. What is the cost price of the table? Enti idi 30. Idi rupees anukuntabba. The market price of the table, ento aithe meeku enduku edo oka number undi akkada ante chaalu. The market price of the table is 30 rupees more than the cost price. If the table is sold after giving a discount of 20% and still earn profit of 10%. From this, can we calculate cost price or not? See, how much discount is given? 20%. Then you will be selling at 80% of market price. And still there is a profit of 10%, that is 110% of cost price. From this, can't we calculate 100% of the market price in terms of percentage of cost price? Yes or no? We are adding 1/4, right? Ikkada kuda 1/4 add cheyali. Avuna kada? Right. What is 1/4? Half, half, 27 and half. That is 127 and half. Market price is 127 and half percent of cost price. Which is how much percent above the cost price? 27.5% of cost price, which is equal to 30 rupees. Cost price is 100%. Can't we calculate this? Will you get answer or not? Right. Whatever the number it is, you have some number, maybe 30 or 300 or 3000, whatever it is. You know that in terms of a number, extra percentage 27.5%, which is equal to number given, 100%, we can calculate. Yes. Next. 1 alone sufficient? The market price of the article is 1100. Will you get answer using 2 alone? Is it required for us anyway? No. 1 alone sufficient, but not 2 alone. Quadratic. Data regarding number of boys and girls. Easy, right? Right. Just need to give numbering, that's it. Once if you have numbers, then it is fine. Should be percentage or average or ratio. Ante kada undedi? What percent? Ante kada? Should be easy one, yes or no?